Hi friends, welcome to Any Creation. If you are new to our channel, subscribe to our channel for more craft videos. Today we will make this Buddha clay mural. I've used canvas board. It's fine art canvas board. The dimensions are 12 into 16 inches. You will require baby powder, cold cream. I have used Nivea cold cream. Any brand is okay. For clay, I have used Fevicryl Shilpakar clay. It's an epoxy based clay. I have a roller, but I didn't much use it. So if you have it, it's great. Otherwise, it's okay. Some clay modeling tools. Epoxy clay has two parts. One will be the hardener, another will be PVC. To mix the epoxy clay, just apply cold cream in your hands so that it doesn't stick to your hands. Remove the parts. And you can see this black one is a hardener part and another white part will be the PVC. If you see in local brands, they will have something called M-Seal. But the problem with M-Seal is it's very hard. It will dry soon so that you have to be very fast when you are working. But Shilpakar clay, it takes some time to harden. So you can easily work on it. You can make your shapes and everything. How you have to mix the clay is equally mix, combine together so that like how you make chapati dough, you just mix it so well that make sure that you mix both of them together. If you want, you can apply more cold cream. If you feel it is very hard, just apply some cold cream inside, or you can even put powder so that you can, it will be little bit easy to work on it. So here I am actually combining the clay so that it has to combine so well. Before doing any other artwork, we have to combine it. So take some time and combine it. We will see how to make few basic shapes before we start doing the mural work. Here I am just rolling it to make it as a sphere. With the sphere, you can do any shapes you want. Like right now, I'm going to roll it into a circle. I'm using the roller. If you don't have a roller, you can still use some pen or the back of a brush, anything, you can use it. You can roll it like this. See, the clay is like very soft right now to work on it. So these are the some shapes which I'm showing so that you can work on it. Another shape which we have started using in the mural is like the creeper shape, because there are lots of roots which we do it. So just keep a flat base and start rolling it. Roll as thin as possible. If you see one place, if it is bigger, then roll over that place so that you can make it as a thin shape. So like a worm. Actually, I'm making it like a worm. So this shape is one shape which we have used it all over the mural. If you see, I have applied it over the roots and we have used it over here. Another shape which we kept on using is, it's a normal round which you can use it. Like for the Buddha hair, we have used a normal round and pierce a hole on it. When you pierce it a hole on top of it, you can see it will give an another shape of it. So if you don't have any clay tool, you can still go and take a pen and you can pierce it, or a pencil you can use it for piercing it. To apply the Shilpakar clay on the canvas board, you have to first apply Fevicol glue or any white glue you have, and then paste the Shilpakar clay over there so that it will stick well together. Right now I'm rolling into a cylindrical shape for the branches and then for the trunk, and then flattening it over there. To get the trunk effect, you can actually take a sharp object and put a scroll or line on top of it so that you can see the branch effect over here. Just go ahead and apply it for all the branches. I have used a reference pic from the internet and I have used as drawn it. Since I'm going to gift it, I'm not trying to sell this object. So I don't know who is the real one owner of the drawing. But you can take any reference picture from the internet and you can use the same for drawing. If you are not good at drawing, you can actually trace it in a tracing paper and use carbon paper down, and then you can draw it on top also. You can do the same also. Here if you have seen, you can see that I'm doing the branches and I'm applying the same on the canvas board. It's a quite a long process. It actually the whole mural took me 8.5 hours. So sit back and relax and enjoy. I'll play some music so that you can see the process in step by step process. And it's a long video, I'm sure, but I didn't want to hide anything, how any process has been done, so that you can really see how it has been done and you can actually do it and enjoy it over here.
Thank you.
using black gesso for painting the base. So if you don't have black gesso, it's okay. You can actually use black acrylic paint. If you wish, you could have painted the base completely with black and then drawn on the top, but it would haven't been that visible. Either you could have used white pencil, but since I didn't want to do that, I have applied all the mural, everything clay, and then painting it all the gaps. Inspired you and you have done this mural, please share it with us in our social sites. I have given all the social sites link in the description and even the materials which has been used in the description below. Thanks for watching till the end of the video. Please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel.